Never make a permanent decision based on a temporary situation. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Turf Talk. My name is Brett Summers. Today is Thursday. It is the day that we bring you Turf Talk, a show that is meant to help parents and help athletes take their game to the top. Today's whole format is going to be revolving around one simple thing. It's trying to help you guys get through the rough patches that you're going to run into in your athletic journeys. I've ran into hard patches. Britt's run into them, Blake's ran into them, the whole crew has ran into them, and I'm sure you out there, you or your son or your daughter has ran into tough situations in their sport. They come in many different ways. Injuries, sideline due to grades, sideline due to a poor attitude on the team. Maybe your skill set isn't good enough to get you into the game, or maybe, just maybe, you're quitting on yourself and you're not getting to where you need to be so that you can get in the starting lineup. Whatever the case may be, I'm sure you or your son or daughter has been in a lot of situations where sports seem too difficult to endure. And that's what brings me to that initial concept that I just gave you guys at the beginning of this show, is you never want to make a permanent decision based on a temporary situation. So I'll use myself as an example. Now, when I look back on my high school athletics, because I'm assuming that a lot of you guys, especially high school football players out there, are watching the show, you can relate a little bit. When I was a high school athlete at Menominee Falls High School, I played my freshman year, my sophomore year, and my junior year in high school football. Now, my sophomore year, on the first day of practice, no pads, I broke my collarbone. It snapped off, and it was actually hitting me in the side of the face. And my coaches told me to keep practicing, but then when I pulled my shirt back and said, hey, the bone's hitting me in the face, they told me, okay, you can go to the trainer's room, who cussed me out and told me to get out until I slipped and fell and re-broke it, even worse. But in any event, so sophomore year, I break my collarbone. Junior year, I make it through the season. I'm not starting, but I'm getting my reps and getting better. And then I break my forearm and I break my wrist on the same play. Now, senior year, I knew I really wanted to focus on baseball, but that's not the true story. I didn't play my senior year of football because of the fear of maybe having another one of those injuries, okay? So I made a permanent situation to, after 2 weeks, I went through the hell weeks, I decided I was gonna focus on baseball and not play football. Now, I love football. I loved football. I played it from the time I was in like first grade all the way up until I was at that age of 16 or 17. And when I was 17, I made a permanent decision based on the fact that I didn't know if I was gonna get injured. I didn't know if I was gonna hurt myself. I was afraid of having to go through that rehabilitation process again. And that fear and that struggle of, will I hurt something or will I end up on the sidelines again? That fear led me to making a permanent lifelong decision to not play that senior year of football, which would have been my last year of football. Now, it's one of those things I've always regretted because I wish I would have been more mentally strong and been more prepared for it. And at the time, I wish maybe my folks would have said, hey, here's really what the situation is. You're making a permanent decision that you can never go back and change, and you're doing that based on a temporary fear. So all of you athletes out there, whatever it is, maybe it's your grades. Maybe you guys aren't like me and you're not worried about injury. Maybe your grades and your studies, you're not able to balance it. And just because in that moment you're not able to balance it, you make the decision to quit your sport. I think that's a bad decision. Maybe you need to step back and assess where you're spending your time and wasting your time on social media, scrolling other people's Instagram accounts, comparing yourselves to other people, getting into school drama. Maybe those things are taking up so much time that you're not able to prioritize your studies and your athletics. How about one of those situations that a lot of us have been in where you're a backup? You're not the number one starter. And instead of improving your skill set, instead of using that struggle and that battle that it's going to take to get you to start, you decide in your head, maybe it'd be better to just quit the sport altogether, give it up, and go a different direction. I'm not good enough right now. I'm going to make the permanent decision to cut off my whole athletics career. Don't make the permanent decision based on where you are. Make sure that you assess the situation. Step back, talk to people, talk to your coach, talk to your parents, talk to friends or family, talk to someone who cares and who wants to listen to you. I don't want to see you guys making these long-term decisions based on where you're currently at. Some of you may be thinking about where you want to go to college. You may be thinking about, you may have offers from schools in New York or may have offers from schools in Florida, but you're from right here in good old Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And thinking about leaving your family and thinking about leaving your comfy, cozy little nest that in the cocoon you're in where mama bird's dropping the worms in your mouth every day, maybe that frightens you and you say, oh, I'm just so comfortable where I am right now. I'm gonna make the decision right now because of where I am to not go to college, and I'm gonna stay right here, and I'm gonna go to lacrosse, and I'm gonna play D3 instead of going to play D1. Now, there's nothing wrong with lacrosse, but if your fear and your current self-limiting beliefs are holding you back from going out and stretching out and getting out of your comfort zone, that decision, based on where you're at mentally at that point in your life, is a bad decision and maybe one that you might regret. So again, you're making this big permanent decision you can never take back because of your temporary situation. So you definitely want to avoid that. What was another one I used? Well, let's just say you're gonna give up on your sport because you're not big enough or strong enough or fast enough. I've had so many kids walk through the doors right here at the good old Top Shop, where we do strength and conditioning training and nutrition training for athletes who want to improve their game. They might be C or D players, and we can take them to being B or A players. I've had kids that were fifth string or kids that didn't even play football one year. And the next year they come in here and they are automatically gonna work as hard as they possibly can and put themselves in the running for that starting position. You have to think of other options other than that option to just quit. A lot of times in life, a lot of times in sports, a lot of times in relationships, in the current situation, in the present, it's a little ugly, it's a little rough, it's a little uncomfortable, things aren't going your way. But if you just take a step back for a minute and assess where it could have the potential to go, you'll see that your current situation doesn't have to be ruined forever in the future because of canceling or quitting or retreating on your initial goals to make that relationship, that business, that athletics career grow. So make sure you don't make the decisions as an athlete or as a parent based on where you're at. Think about where you could be and what other options you have to getting there. That leads me to this. A lot of athletes out there, whether they're trying to get bigger, stronger, and faster, whether it may be a football player like some of the guys Blake's working with or a soccer athlete like some of the gals that Britt wants to work with, perhaps you guys want to improve, you want to get better, but your situation right now, you're like, well, the school weight room, nobody really helps me, and you know, my coach says he or she really wants to help me get better for soccer, for football, or baseball, or whatever sport it is, but no one ever takes the time to work with me one-on-one or help me get better. That is why we created the Top Shop. That is what we have been doing here since 2008. Next month will actually be 11 years of helping athletes go from being backups to being supporting cast members on the team who are maybe there to high five and encourage the starters, to taking them and putting them into that starting role, and not only developing their physicality, but also helping them now develop their skill set as a football player, as a soccer athlete. So I want you guys to remember, when you're in those tough situations, when you don't look, it doesn't look like you're gonna be in the starting lineup, it doesn't look like you physically have what it takes, it doesn't look like mentally you're as prepared for the game if you're a quarterback and you just don't know how to read defenses yet, that's temporary. That's not permanent. That's something that can be changed. That doesn't mean you don't have a real good football IQ forever. That means that right now you don't have a good football IQ. Soccer has an IQ. Baseball has an IQ, which I found out the hard way when I went to UWM. Scott Duffick, our head baseball coach, or one of the head baseball coaches at the time, he gave us all a test. And the test asked us several different questions. How do you move a runner over? How do you do this? How do you do that? I failed the test miserably. I had no clue. Everything was hit a home run. Everything was throw a runner out. Everything was doing what I thought my job was. It was all selfish. That didn't mean I was going to be the dumbest baseball player in the history, although at the time I could have made a case for being that. But what it meant was permanently or temporarily in that spot, I needed to get my game right. I needed to read a book. I read a book at that time. It was called Smart Baseball. Smart Baseball was basically a book that was developed to give a baseball player a really good IQ and teach you all sorts of little different things. When I started reading that book and I started talking to my coach more, all of a sudden I started to become a better player. I started to understand that if there's a runner on first and no outs, if I can move him over to second, I can put him into scoring position. And now the next single that gets hit might score that runner. That seems like a small thing, but later on in my career, I ended up being the leader in sacrifice bunts. Now I'm a home run hitter, but I ended up leading my team always in sacrifice bunts because I knew when certain situations came up, I could get my job done. So if it's smarts or if it's again, maybe it's just an insecurity. Maybe you just don't, you know you want to play sports and maybe you're not going all in, or your son or daughter is just nervous about going to play sports because they don't think that they're good enough. I'm begging you parents to remind them that while they may not seem super athletic now, they may not seem super prepared now, or they may not seem super skilled right now, if they put the work in and get themselves in an environment around people who truly care about them and they put the time and the effort in and the passion in, anything is possible for them. They can overcome any adversity that comes their way if they're willing to work hard at it. So that's all I really wanted to make sure I got across to you guys in this podcast. It was going to be simple. It was going to be short and sweet. But I don't like to see people make decisions that can impact the rest of their life. And they end up like me, sitting there, 33 years old, bald, old, blown out muscles left and right, and thinking, man, what could I have done if I would have put the work in? And if I would have put the work in, how much more confident could I have been? And I could have even been more confident and know and say, hey, injury is a potential risk in football. But I put the work in, I'm mentally prepared, and I'm ready to rock and roll. I wish I would have done that. I'm hoping that this video hits just one person or one family member who knows that their son or daughter is thinking about retreating and quitting on their future goals of becoming a Major League Baseball player or an MLS soccer player. What's the women's MLS? Is it just called MLS? Soccer? WMLS? Or is it just MLS?
MLS.
Dang, see, it's all one and the same now, ladies and gentlemen. Your goals can come true. Blake's laughing. I don't know. I'm not a soccer buff. All I know is if those are your dreams, you can get there if you put the work in. You'll have the confidence to make those life-changing decisions like I had to make. I remember crying in the locker room. I remember being all upset. The fact that I was crying should have showed me that I needed to get my game right and get back out there on that football field, especially after making it through the 2 weeks. And I regret it, and I don't want you guys to regret it. Okay? Now, I went and poured all that energy into baseball. It turned out to be a good decision, but I still wish I would have got out on that football field for one more year and enjoyed that 1 year of brotherhood that you can only get through a sport like football. All of you guys out there, it's Thursday. Tomorrow is Friday. Some of you may be competing, or some of you guys may be in your off season. If you're a basketball player, your season's going to be starting pretty quickly here. Mason Martinez has been a basketball player in here and has made a phenomenal progression as a sophomore in high school. He's getting bigger and stronger. He's stronger than guys that are juniors and seniors in high school, and he's a basketball player. He's getting faster and more athletic. If that sounds like something you need, whether you're a young female athlete or a male athlete, you need to get into Top Shop. You need to get in here and get better and spend your off season with us improving your skill set, improving your confidence, and improving your swagger out on that field so that when those situations come up that are going to try you and test you and push you and grind you and beat you down, you're mentally and physically prepared to be able to handle them, and you come out on top, because that's always what we're aiming for. I hope you guys have an awesome Thursday. Get ready for your games tomorrow. If you don't have one, get in the Top Shop, start eating right, start getting your sleep, and for crying out loud, get your studies done. It's just high school or college. You guys can handle it. We'll see you guys soon.